The Whole Foods early. Get everything to get that soul food working, like mac and cheese, the collard greens, the black eyed peas.
So guys, welcome back to the channel. Today it isn't a Bass Lucille, it's me with my new microphone, the Blue Snowball, so I hope this sounds a bit better. Today obviously is Vegan News in the Week by your host, Tofu Tommy. The first article we want to touch upon is the Daily Mirror. It says about piles of pig bones found in woods next to farm which supplies pork to Tesco. A dozen skulls and mounds of remains were found dumped on land registered in Hogwood Farm. So as you can see here guys, disturbing pig graveyard found in near worst farm in Britain. This is actually supplying to Tesco, as it says piles of pig bones in a grisly woodland graveyard have been found next to a farm which supplies pork of Tesco's. A dozen skulls and mounds of remains were found dumped on land registered to Hogwood Farm where shocking conditions were exposed by the Sunday Mirror last month. Campaigners from animal charity Viva discovered the graveyard near Brian Hobber's farm. Near pictures obtained last week clearly show the 12 skulls, some still with ear tags. Absolutely disgusting, guys. Viva founder Juliet Gellatley said, "We were appalled to find the pig graveyard in Hobbell's Wood. Mounds of pig bones were piled high, covered in moss and undergrowth." Just basically thrown away like trash, basically. It just shows you the type of things that we actually do to the animals. They're just commodities, basically. It's all about money, and at the end of the day we just chuck them out like trash. A dozen skulls and mounds of remains were found. Remains were found near Hogwood Farm, as you can see there. They said it's a risk to human health, but also shows a blatant disrespect for these poor pigs who have endured the life of suffering and misery at the hands of their farmer. It's so unnecessary. Walking into woods strewn with bodily remains, it felt like I'd walked into an aftermath of a war zone. Unmarked graves for animals who were just a number. And that's exactly what it is. Like I say, they're just a number. Pigs are sentient beings. Like I say, it's terrible the things that they actually do to the animals. You think of all the cruelty that goes on, and this is basically just shows you that you just basically put them down to monetary gain. We found 12 skulls, jaws, shoulder bones and legs scattered around in a mound filled with rotting remains like a macabre scene from a horror film. But these victims were alive and suffered and died for nothing. Exactly. The Sunday Mirror told last month how the pigs crammed into a barn were found chomping on rotten carcasses. Sickening film taken by activists showed another dead hog with a huge wound being eaten by the 15,000 pigs packed into the farm. So as you can see there guys, that just shows you the actual shocking images. The skulls of two more pigs and a jawbone and a leg that had been developed in the same pen were a clear breach of DEFRA guidelines. Juliet went on, "Our initial investigation exposed widespread abuse and a disgustingly dirty red tractor at Proof Factory Farm. Inside this hellhole we filmed cannibalism, sickly dying pigs and wheelbarrows of fully dead, rotting animals. Cannibalism is not a natural behaviour for pigs, it is caused by the bleak environment." Exactly, that's exactly what it is. It's basically, it's the environment that they're crammed into. "Now this shoddy graveyard shows a total disregard for animals. Government guidelines state the burial of burning of falling stock in the open is banned to prevent the risk of spreading disease from the residue in the soil, groundwater or air pollution. Viva campaigners were tipped off by a rambler who spotted the skeletons at the woodland in Warwickshire. Details have been passed to Trading Standards, Environmental Health and Animal and Plant Health Agency." Julia added, "Hogwood typifies institutionalised cruelty sanctioned by government. It's understood that Tesco officials inspected the farm in recent weeks." So I'm going to follow this on here. Tesco said, "We take animal welfare extremely seriously and expect producers to meet recognised standards as well as our own stringent industry leading requirements. Our dedicated agriculture team, Red Tractor and Animal and Plant Health Agency visit farms regularly and claims standards have not been reached and are fully investigated." Mr. Hobble said, "The bones were found in the woods are likely to predate the burial ban on fallen stock, which was introduced in 2003, before that farmers were legally permitted to bury fallen stock." So guys, following up on this, if you go into the Viva campaign's website, it says Tesco Hogwood Farm Day of Action, August 12th. Order your materials today. Tesco have so far refused to drop Hogwood as a supplier, and you'll have seen there that they said they were following stringent guidelines. They wouldn't actually condone any of this, and they were looking into things. So that's a bit of hypocrisy going on here. So we think their customers should see for themselves exactly what was found at the farm. The farm's vet approval, this hellhole, Tesco approved it, the Red Tractor Assurance Scheme approved it, and so did the government. It tells us all we need to know about the state of animal welfare in Britain today. The best in the world, what a sick joke. Thousands of farms, millions of animals, and when we file cruelty complaints with federal evidence, mostly we don't get a reply. Tesco is one of Hogwood's customers and therefore shares the guilt. Exactly, they share the guilt and basically they're condoning this. They can't continue to close ranks and cry cruelty, what cruelty. Supermarket welfare assurances are meaningless. Open a door, drop packer pack for local distribution or a demo pack for handing out leaflets for your local Tesco with posters and other free materials on Saturday, August 12th. I'll actually put the link for this down below, guys. Like I say, please go and share this about if you can as well. Like I say, Tesco are basically showing pure hypocrisy, and it just shows you that they're valuing their monetary gain over the welfare of animals and their so-called ethical guidelines and stringent guidelines. So guys, the next article we're actually going to touch upon today is Impossible Food Burger Tested on Animals. And this is from the Vegan Life magazine. It makes you actually wonder how many so-called ethically vegan products are actually tested on animals. This is absolutely terrible, and like I say, it really, really puts out a bad message, because we think we're doing the right thing, we're saving animals, and yet they're actually being tested on animals, which is just basically total hypocrisy. It has been revealed that the company behind plant-based Bleeding Impossible Burger, tested a key ingredient at animals that adhere to food safety standards. In their If Safety and Transparency document, the company said that Impossible Burger is made through a simple, deliberate combination of plant-based ingredients. Great that it's made from plant-based ingredients. One of the few ingredients in the Impossible Burger, but you may not know, one that you can't buy at your local grocery store, is soy leghemoglobin. Soy leghemoglobin is a protein that carries heme, an iron-containing molecule that occurs naturally in every animal and plant. They go on to say in 2014, two years before selling our first product, Impossible Foods performed numerous studies to evaluate the safety of soy leghemoglobin. In 2016, we also conducted a stringent rat feeding study to examine whether consumption of leghemoglobin in quantities more than 100-fold greater than normal dietary exposure would produce any adverse effects. Everyday rats consumed the equivalent of more than 200 times the amount of heme in the form of leghemoglobin that the average American consumes daily from ground beef. Could you imagine what the cruelty that they actually suffered in that? In addition to daily observations of overall health, growth and behaviour, a meticulous examination of the rat's organs found no evidence of adverse effects from this massive overconsumption of soy leghemoglobin. Despite the FDA, Food and Drug Administration that is, has refused to confirm the ingredient is safe to eat, saying FDA believes the arguments presented individually and collectively do not establish the safety of soy leghemoglobin for consumption. Whether or not it's safe to eat, frankly, beside the point for vegans. The ingredients may be plant-based, but the burger, if its component ingredients are tested on animals, is not cruelty-free. These burgers, however, have been confirmed as 100% vegan. So, oh yeah, they're 100% vegan. I'm really sure of that. Like I say, that's exploitation in every sense of the word. If anything's tested on animals, it's not vegan. That's just like going into a store and buying something that says meat free, but yeah, it's got egg whites and things on it. Animal exploitation in every sense of the word. Anything that's tested on animals is not vegan, and that basically just shows you, it makes you wonder what other products out there that are saying that they're 100% vegan are tested on animals. Absolutely terrible, and I thought I would share this with you guys. Like I say, if you've got any more articles you would like me to cover, please let me know in the comments below. Let me know if the sound is any better today on this broadcast. And as always, binge on life, purge negativity, and starve guilty feelings. And just before we go, a little vegan connotation that I've just made up, guys. This spells it all. Be kind to every kind. Tofu doesn't scream, go vegan. Speak to you all soon, guys. Love you so, so, so much. Binge on life, purge negativity, and starve guilty feelings. Speak to you all soon and love you so much.